Good morning. Welcome to Unity Spiritual Center of Woodstock. We are so grateful you are here. And it's the first Sunday after Easter. You all survived and you're in the house. Nice job. Really glad that you are here. My name is Reverend Marypatriece Wendt.
Oh, and I'm Reverend Tom Wendt. And it's just, I was waiting for her to inform you that she's the spiritual leader of our ministry, of our church. So here I am. Let's start over. Hi, I'm Reverend Tom Wendt. It's a joy to be here today. Oh, bye.
I surprised you. That's okay. All right. I do change things up once in a while.
Oh, I'm telling you.
Let's go ahead and start with a prayer. Let's take a deep breath. Divine life flowing through me, the very song that I breathe, the life force that I exude, and the expression that I am, thank you for today, for this moment, for all that are here, all that are tuning in, and all that want to be here, but for whatever reason, will feel our presence and our care with them, no matter where they may be. Thank you for the life that connects us all and the gifts that continue to show us the way to be a better community, to be a more connected, caring life force. Thank you for this time, place, and space, and for the gift that each breath brings. And so it is. Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's go ahead and start with our five unity principles.
We're ready.
Are you ready?
Yep.
I thought I'd check in with you. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, God the good omnipotence. The Christ Spirit lives within me. Thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. I experience God's presence and power through prayer and meditation. I put my faith into action by demonstration. Unity is about living a life that is more spiritual than religious. That means that we don't prescribe any kind of rituals or any kind of prayers that you have to follow. It means that we know that there is an internal guidance system that is already in you, innately operating through you, and that as you tune in and you find that still small voice, you have all that you need, and you can rely on it. You can move with that and make decisions from that because we have the gift already within, the life force that drives us and breathes us and holds us in every moment is there to support us in every moment. And our goal here is really just to support one another on our journey, whatever that journey looks like. And you get to choose what that is for you. You have anything you want to share with that?
The power's in us, people. Let's use it.
Mm-hmm. Great. This morning, USCW would be so grateful to accept your gift at unitywoodstock.org. We are self-supporting here, and all your donations are an investment in the talks, in the groups, and in the events that we host here. If you are in the sanctuary with us, please take out your gift and hold it in your hands. If you are at home or visiting us on Facebook, please hold the amount in your mind and your heart. And when you're ready, you can just go to our Joy of Giving tab, whether it's here, or go to our website, unitywoodstock.org, and go to the Joy of Giving tab. Let's bless what we have. Seeing it moving out into the world, multiplying, touching all those, reaching all those that need it. Seeing it bless us as we join in the circle of abundance, that as we give, we receive, and as we receive, we give. Thank you for the gift that this brings us and that the gift that we get to share. And we'll say a short prayer. Divine love flowing through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Amen.
Amen. So it is. So this is my time where I get to share with you who is helping to support us today. And on our tech team, we have George Mulligano with us again this morning. Mm-hmm. Kim Joswiak, our Facebook guru. And our introductory, if you've seen the introduction to our service, she does all of that, as well as her husband, Joe Joswiak. Thank you so much. They make the magic happen, as well as our other magician, our music leader, Ken Johnson. Thank you so much. We're so grateful for you. And I'm going to turn it over to you to keep the magic going.
Like the pine trees lining the winding road, I got a name. I got a name. Like the singing bird and the croaking toad, I've got a name. I've got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did. But I'm living a life that he kept hid. Moving me down the highway, moving me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Like the north wind whistling down the sky, I've got a song. I've got a song. Like the whippoorwill and the baby's cry, I've got a song. I've got a song. And I carry it with me and I sing it loud. If it gets me nowhere, I'll go there proud. Moving me down the highway, moving me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Gonna go there free, like the man I am and I'll always be. I've got a dream. I've got a dream. You can change your mind, but you can't change me. I've got a dream. I've got a dream. I know I can't share it if you want me to. If you're going my way, I'll go with you. Moving me down the highway, moving me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Moving me down the highway, moving me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by.
Thank you. Thank you. Would you enter into a time of reflection with me? Let's start with some deep breaths. so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed.
Dear friends, as we enter into this time of guided meditation, I invite each of us to carry that idea that Ken just placed in our consciousness. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. Can you breathe into that idea, that state of consciousness? Breathe deeply. I am so blessed. Let us think of all the things that blessed us this morning. Yes, there may have been some challenges, dear friends. We don't deny that. And I am inviting each of us to count our blessings this morning. Down to the little things that mattered to you that perhaps no one else would have noticed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. Surrender to that idea. I am so grateful for all that I have. My, oh my. Let us imagine ourselves as the pot of gold at the end of our rainbow. I am so blessed. I am so grateful that my gratitude will continue throughout this day and beyond. God, I'm blessed. I am fortunate to be alive. I breathe in blessings, and I exhale gratitude for all that I have, for all that I am. God, I'm blessed. Today, the name I give myself is blessed. And today, I allow the peace and understanding of the blessings that surround me and flow within me and through me to direct my day. And so today is a day of peacefulness, calmness, blessings and gratitude. My God, what a day. And as we bring our attention back to this time and place, let's do so in a continual state of being blessed and bestowing blessings on others, simply by means of our presence. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ken.
Mm-hmm. So our talk title today is The Path Less Traveled. Estefan has driven a cab in Chicago for the last 12 years. He has a really heavy accent and a big, bright smile. And every person, passenger that gets in, he greets with warmth. Oftentimes, someone will ask him, "Where are you from?" And he'll tell them, "If you can guess where I am from, your fare is free." I guess no one's figured it out so far, but maybe after his story gets out, his secret will be pretty much out there. Estefan was born and raised in Basra, Iraq, and his cousin introduced him to the world of boxing at 18. And he had a natural talent for this, so natural that he easily moved into this field and became a professional in that country. He was well known, not only for being a professional boxer, but for also being a professional goalkeeper for the country's soccer team. And at one point, the government came to him and said, "Would you consider becoming a member of the national boxing team?" And they sent him 5 times to training. And 5 times they sent him back home with no explanation. His cousin, he was very disillusioned, and even his cousin who introduced him to this You know, there's something wrong here. But he was very disillusioned, and he decided, you know what? I need to leave. My opportunities are limited here. I need to leave this country. So in 1976, he took a flight, but he couldn't go with and tell anyone he was leaving the country because he would either be jailed or killed because he was so well known. So he took a plane, and you know, his story was that he was going on vacation, and he left and went to Greece. And when he got to Greece, he started working in a local factory and showing up at the gym there and started boxing again. And they immediately recognized his talent and said, come back, keep coming every day, please. So after a while, he became so well known, even in Greece, with the people, locals around there, that again, he was approached. And they asked, would you consider becoming a boxer to represent Greece? And he said, no, I can't. I can't do that. He would lose his anonymity if he did that. So while he was there, of course, he met someone, a very beautiful woman there. And he was so enchanted by her. And he asked her, you know, he wanted to date her, and she was resisting because she had no desire to be in Greece. She was from Iraq. He found out. But her goal was to get to the United States. And he said, if you go there, I will follow you. And so they got married, and then they moved to the Chicago area. From that time on, as soon as he got into Chicago, he again started going back into the boxing field, and again he started, you know, showing up at the gyms. But now he's a little older, you know, he's been doing this a while, and so some of the injuries started showing on him, and his face would become bruised and swollen when he came home, and his wife would say, you know, we have children here now. I need you to stop. And so he did. And he became a cab driver. And he works every day, 10 to 12 hours a day, with the biggest smile, and goes home to a wife that hugs and kisses him, and kids, four kids that adore him. He treads the path less traveled. And with courage, I can sing my life song like he does.
Whatever those guys have, I want it. Those were the words stated by Philip Goldberg in an issue in the latest issue of Unity magazine. He stated that phrase as he was standing in a hushed museum in Boston viewing the statues of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. He wanted that. Before long, he took up meditation and other yoga practices, and he became a teacher of transcendental meditation. He believed that peace, prosperity, and justice he and others dreamed of could come to being only by changing the consciousness of everybody, or enough people, where the world would change. You know, that was a common belief among us Unitics a decade or two ago. That was our way of singing our life's song, you might say. But I will say that his personal slogan of changing the world one mantra at a time seemed a little over the top to me. He avoided political and social issues for two reasons. He says, I don't need to follow the news. I know it's always bad. And I know that as we change the consciousness of everyone, the news is going to change. And he didn't want to get involved in social issues either, because it just kept him from creating the inner kind of peace and transformation he wanted to experience. And he was far from the only one who turned from social activism to various forms of inner transformation. He wasn't alone. And as that community changed and evolved and grew, the second part of the plan, the anticipated change of the world, just didn't happen. You see, change cries out for both inner-directed spiritual skills and outer-directed action skills. We need engaged citizens to do their internal spiritual work, to work on themselves inwardly, who care enough about the conditions of the world to become engaged. Everyone can do something to make the world a better place. And it takes nothing more than to access that quiet wisdom within, that quiet source within, maybe that you experienced during our meditation or Ken's wonderful song, I Am So Blessed. Listen for that wisdom of higher wisdom and heed the call to serve the greater good, however that might look. Sounds to me like unity's fifth principle. I put my faith into action by demonstration. And it need not be a colossal effort. You don't need to save the world. It doesn't have to be arduous or sacrificial. Acts of service can, in fact, and ought to be energizing and jubilant and vibrant. The world needs happy warriors, not martyrs. Why shouldn't doing good for others lift the doer? Why shouldn't doing service to others serve the person providing the service also? Regular spiritual practice is not simply a rest stop, but a fueling station. It is not merely an escape valve, but see it as a launching pad to do what is ours to do. You might think of it as a spiritual two-step. Step one is to turn within, access the divine wisdom, the presence of God in us, the Christ Spirit within. Acknowledging our essential unity with all, and then, step two, step boldly into an active life, fully equipped to fulfill our responsibilities in this world to make a change for the good. And remember, no gesture is too small and no gesture is insignificant.
So what I'm hearing is that Philip started out on a more solitary path.
He did.
He was in ashrams probably and things like that. And he was moving through a path of solitude that isolated him from others. And I think about our master teacher did very similar things. In his early life, he spent a lot of time in the temples. He spent a lot of time learning and going within and understanding that inner space, that inner guidance system. He learned and listen to his inner rhythm, that inner movement of energy, that life song that was playing inside. He became intimately familiar with the words that were singing, moving with that energy, the truths that were coming through, and applying them. He became more of a public figure, applying them for social change. Philip also discovered that the true path less traveled appeared at first to be that one of being isolated and out in the quiet and in meditation and all those wonderful things. Mm-hmm. But perhaps he then realized that the path less traveled is the one you take when you move back into society with the truth that you know within, the message that is playing in you. There's no one else that can give it but you. Through regular spiritual practices, we learn our inner song. We learn our life song and can apply it in our lives. In Exodus chapter 15, verse 2, it says, "The Lord is my strength and my song." There is a spirit ready to sing through you. Do you feel the rhythm of spirit in you? The song that longs to come through your voice? Have you ever been enraptured by that presence that makes you want to jump for joy and dance and sing? Maybe you do it. Is there an unquenchable joy that you feel when you're expressing it? And when you're not, perhaps that feeling of being bottled up, feeling frustrated, feeling tired and overwhelmed. Perhaps you're noticing circumstances around you that you're not in sync with. And perhaps you're in an environment where you're a part of that. Maybe you're feeling helpless. Maybe you're feeling powerless. Maybe trapped or anxious. But could this be an opportunity for growth? Could this be an opportunity for you to know that life song in you and sing it out into the situation that you find yourself in? If you are facing an opportunity like that, you're not alone. I'm right there with you. Let's take a moment right now to go into the silence, to breathe into that song that's playing inside of us, to listen to the words that are coming through us. Let that rhythm move you. Turn up the volume. Let it flow and listen. Bring up circumstance that's bothering you right now. Bring it to mind. Keep listening for the music and the words inside of it. What are they saying? Let them take root in your consciousness and breathe in deep. Make a commitment to saying them. And then return to the room. A Christian band called Casting Crown has a song called Life Song. And the lyrics go like this. Empty hands held high, such small sacrifice. If not joined with my life, I sing in vain tonight. May the words I say and the things I do make my life song sing, bring a smile to you. Let my life song sing to you. I want to sing your name to the end of my day, knowing that my heart was true. Am I singing my life song right now? Or am I barely able to hum the melody? Psalm chapter 69, verse 30 says, I will praise God's name in song and glorify him with thanksgiving. With courage, I sing my life song today.
I liked your question, am I singing my life song right now, or am I barely able to hum the melody? That's a good question for me to ask myself in some areas of my life. I like that. Well, Brené Brown, in her book titled Daring Greatly, quotes from a speech by Theodore Roosevelt. I've paraphrased it to remove most of the male-oriented nature that was common at the times, and you've heard this before, but some things bear repeating. It is not the critic who counts, not the one who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the one who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short again and again. Because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends oneself in a worthy cause, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if they fail, at least fail while daring greatly. My opening story about Philip Goldberg and those in his philosophical company attempting to change the world solely by making the people in it reflective and contemplative is a story of daring greatly and failing in terms of meeting the ultimate goal. I call it being redirected from what we thought could be to what else is possible. No doubt Philip was better off for making that commitment and making the attempt than he would have been had he remained on the sidelines pointing out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. Brené Brown says that wholehearted living is about engaging in our lives from a place of worthiness. It means cultivating our courage, compassion, and conviction and connection to wake up in the morning and say, no matter what gets done and how much stuff is left undone, I am enough. She says it's going to bed at night thinking, yes, I am imperfect and vulnerable and sometimes afraid. But that doesn't change the truth that I am also brave and worthy of love and belonging. The quest lesson this week was about our unique way. It contains the quote, "To really evolve as an individual, it will be necessary for you not to follow the crowd." If you're in unity, chances are you've already left the crowd behind, at least in some areas of your life. And your unique journey continues. Where are you called to leave the crowd again? Where are you called to leave the crowd and fully rely on the Christ in you for direction, your internal spiritual GPS? Chancing that your face will be marred by dust and sweat and blood. I mean, you're already doing the inner spiritual work. Where can you step boldly into active life, fully equipped to fulfill your responsibilities and make the world a better place? And remember, no gesture is too small and no gesture is insignificant. Where can you completely commit to wholehearted living, stepping into the risk of becoming either a success or a failure in creating a world that works for all? There is no better time than right now to step into that place and with courage to sing your life song.
In closing, Estefan and Philip are both using their life song to make changes in the world. Are you singing, not humming, your life song? I confess I still hum a little too often. Mm-hmm. Like our master teacher Jesus, we accept the path less traveled when we live our life song through spiritual practices and application in our real world. And so it is. Namaste.
Namaste.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Sing it with me now. This light of mine, hey, I'm gonna let it shine. Hey, this light of mine, I'm gonna let it. I'm gonna let it shine. Hey, hey, hide under the bush. Oh no, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide under a bush. Oh no, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. River, drop me in the water. come on now, take me to the river. Yeah, drop me in the water. Take me to the river. Drop me in the water. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let's sing it all together now. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Yeah, here we go. This little light of mine, yeah, yeah, I'm gonna let it shine. Sounding good in this little light of mine. Hey, I'm gonna let it shine. 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 Let it shine.
Thank you so much. Wow. Okay, so we've got a few announcements real quick. Please check the upcoming calendar, the e-blast, our website with all the new things that are going on, because there's going to be new things going on. And today, of course, we're having our church chat right after the service. Please stay for that. You'll get to ask questions. You'll get to hear information about where we are, what our plans are, what's coming up. And if you need some prayer support, we have Miriam with us this morning, our prayer chaplain. She will support you there. There's also the prayer box here. You can fill out a form, and it will be put on a list that's prayed over for 30 days, as well as sent to Silent Unity to be prayed over for another 30 days. Please like or subscribe this video, if you would, please. That way you will be notified when new ones come out. And let's see, anything else that I'm thinking of? I think
we're... Does anybody else have this fear? If I subscribe to this, I'm going to be overwhelmed by messages. That doesn't happen.
Yeah.
Just know that. That doesn't happen.
Nope.
But it does show people who are following, right?
Yep, it does.
Okay.
And you'll be able to get notifications about the wonderful meditations that go out each week, as well as affirmations that will lift you up during the day. So please consider doing that. And I forgot to say, you know, as you have prepared your offering this morning, there is a basket at the end of the aisle here for those people that are in the building. So let's go ahead and close out with our prayer for protection, and then we will listen to our final song. Okay, ready?
Yep.
The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful week.
We're going to start singing the peace song again.
Yay!
So we'll dispense with the hand-holding, but we'll be close together in spirit. And please rise in body.
Absolutely.
Or spirit, and help me out with this one. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as creator, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every breath I take, let this be my joyous vow. To take
each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Thank you.